Hello, YouTubers. This video will investigate the building blocks of our reality from perspective of mathematics language. In three different concepts, scalar vector units, discrete numbers, and transcendental math numbers in form of transcendental sine, cosine, and exponent functions, which all three are based on extrapolation mathematics operation. In the previous video with the name Fourier series and holographic universe and brains, I tried to explain that 3D world is 2D holographic Fourier math series projection. Video is very dense in philosophy, which very strong evidence of researchers, but it is not physics or math-based video, which is okay. I like philosophy, and that is the longest video that I made. This video will focus on physics and mathematics to prove my point by using real physics examples. Instead of Fourier series, we will use simple trigonometric and exponential functions to prove the point. The theory is such all our representation of the world is based on five senses, based on waves, Schrödinger wave equation, which gives solid our reality in form of solid thought based on Werner Heisenberg matrices of quantum mechanics. Nature, in a wider notion, based belief, the system, God or random nature, took discrete numbers, whole numbers, including zero. Holy Trinity must begin from zero. That is the primordial soup of mathematics, alpha and omega. Everything started from natural whole number, who goes to infinity, and according to mathematician Cantor, it is countable infinity. Cantor Black Monolith Memorial Cube in Germany city, in the city Hall. Natural, including zero, holy numbers is a primordial source for solving old-fashioned conundrum. If God created Earth, who created God in the first place? Alpha and Omega, in Christianity, the first and last letters of Greek alphabet used to designate the comprehensiveness of God, implying that God includes all that can be. Without the black monolith of Cantor, it's very hard to start investigation of foundation of mathematics. Whole numbers required for this theory. In philosophical interpretation, the monolith of whole numbers can be the mysterious teaching of Jacob BOEHME about the Ungrund, about the abyss, without foundation, dark and irrational, before being, is an attempt to provide an answer to the basic question of all questions, the question concerning the origin of the world and the arising of evil. The whole teaching of BOEHME about the Ungrund is so interwoven with the teaching concerning freedom that it's impossible to separate them. For this is all part and parcel of the same teaching, and I am inclined to interpret the Ungrund as a primordial meonic freedom, indeterminate even by God. Meonic means of relating to or consisting of kind of pregnant nothingness or void, as distinguished from an absolute blank nothingness having the potential to transform into matter. I know this is cosmology interpretation of whole numbers, and I am aware that is numerology. Numerology is not number theory, and astronomy is not the same as astrology, cosmology. The starting point must be somewhere. The scientific method must have foundation. You cannot start to prove that reality is mathematics based with a leap of faith. That is Darwinism indoctrination, where all premise of theory based on leap of faith. Ungrund means German under or foundation. Even this foundation is very vague and abstract. But even God must use Ungrund, whole numbers, indeterminate something to create reality. And to create something without nothing is very hard task. Same as claiming that classical mechanics without Newton's laws of motion is possible. And even we agree that Newton's laws of motion are very abstract and vague, but they are not just required, they are essential to start investigate all classical mechanics problems. Cantor countable infinity Aleph index zero will be understanding the building block of our material matter-based surroundings. After primordial monolith, whole numbers go irrational transcendental numbers as waves x value inside sine, cosine and exponential functions. That is where God inserts physics constant that can be irrational numbers like math transcendental constant pi, but also complex numbers, and yes, complex numbers real, not just mathematics novelty. Plus, x value can be changed by humans. Example, speed of light in physics is constant, which is a fact, but what if light beam goes through glass? Constant speed of light becomes smaller. That is indirect manipulation of physics constant by external action. I will show another example in classical mechanics of such constant change. And of course, Holy Trinity is finished with amplitude, capital letter A. God made integers, all else is work of man, quote by mathematician Leopold Kronecker. In my rephrase of mathematician Leonel Kronecker, quote is, God made the physics constant inside transcendental function as x value. Amplitude in front of function is the work of man. Amplitude represents scalar vectorial magnitude, work of mankind. The amplitude can be changed and manipulated easily by humankind interaction. Whole numbers are Ungrund foundation and material building block which goes to infinity. An x value in physics constant inserted by God or random nature inside transcendental function using transcendental mathematics constant E and pi. Extrapolation definition is the action of estimating or concluding something by assuming that existing trend will continue or a current method will remain applicable. Let's say we want to estimate the height of a tree from the picture by extrapolating from a well-known fact that the picture was made perpendicular from the photographer's point of view. Sorry, leaning Pisa Tower holders. That is false perspective example, not extrapolation example. If a global average height of an adult man is 1 meter and 71 centimeter. In the picture, we know by measuring the height of an adult man in millimeters. At the same time, measuring the height of a tree in the picture in millimeters too. We can approximately estimate, or we can say that we can extrapolate the real height of a specific tree depicted in picture. That is Euclidean geometry of proportionality of similar object, for example, similar triangles. Galileo was right about the constant gravity of force. All objects fall at the same acceleration magnitude and are independent of their mass. The fact is proven by Galileo experiments from Pisa Tower by dropping different mass objects. But maybe moon and all planets are much closer to the Earth than we told to think. When our world is based on mathematics, I mean transcendental functions from x variable, exponent, sine, cosine. That is where the random nature or God inserts physics constants that governs our physics laws described by Newton, Maxwell, Bernoulli, Einstein, and other famous physicists. Where natural numbers are building blocks, we will start from decaying exponential function. In physics, exists only one unique exponential function and none others. This statement is so important that sometimes we forget what does it mean. A better example is exponent base 2. A few science branches where exponent base 2 is used to describe some kind of physics process. We care only about e-based exponential function because it is only mathematics function. It is being derived as area of isosceles hyperbola in form of a natural logarithm. That is big difference. In Newtonian and non-Newtonian mechanics, including, existed only one exponential based E. That is why it describes such things as forces, pressure, energy, momentum, units, and etc. In physics, exists only one E based exponent. In pure mathematics, exist infinite based exponents. In engineering, is common 10 based exponential. But that is just convenient because our decimal-based counting system to uses 10 is much easier to calculate magnitudes. Example, decibel sound intensity measurement unit. Even sound decay from distance is E-based function. 10-based exponential and logarithms are caused by the convenience of a decimal-based counting system. An example of what does it mean unique exponential is here in the picture. When we have one exponential function, we can extrapolate infinite many same exponential function in between. Let's say we want half amplitude exponential function, which will give the unique new exponential function. Unique in physics means fundamental E-based exponential function. And we can use a same extrapolation method to get infinite many variations of E-based exponential functions. The same rule can be applied to transcendental functions of sine and cosine, for example, of sound volume magnitude. Our goal is not amplitude, but X extrapolation. Amplitude is the work of humans and will be third part of this video. When we establish extrapolation of amplitude, we need to extrapolate of x value inside exponent. And the best example is the Planck law of black body radiation intensity measured in watts per volume of a body with temperature capital letter T. Frequency is the main protagonist in Max Planck equation. The answer is no. The temperature is a real driver of Planck equation. Frequency is spectrum range and cannot be changed outside temperature T value. Frequency goes from approximately equals to zero to frequency goes to infinity. From the first view, looks like we do not extrapolate anything. Every different curvature of Planck law with different temperature value is a different curve. To convince, we will use very familiar to people shape, the three circles with different radius r values. Let's say we show chord of this three circle. From this point of view, we will look like three different arches. But they are the same described by transcendental math constant pi. You have different arch lengths and the curvatures are different, but they are the same circle shape. Same, and here Planck law is everywhere the same, only temperature, capital T value in exponential transcendental function gives different angle function shape. Similar to circle and Planck law is catenary curve, also described by exponential functions. Function has named as hyperbolic function cosh, also related to cosine function, and curve is catenary in the Latin language, means a chain. Curve resembles very flexible hanging chain under influence of gravity force. In this case, the length S of a curve is a constant value. By changing distance x between two points, we get different angle curves of a same length string chain, similar to different radio circles chords. It is worthwhile to note that catenary has only one shape. It is not a family of curves. If you hold two ends of a string and vary distance of the endings, you will see shapes of different shapeness and wonder how can they all be catenary. In fact, you are merely seeing different scales of catenary. The phenomenon is the same as looking at part of a circle. The closer you look, the straighter it is, but the whole circle never changes shape. At each instant you are holding the string, the law of physics dictates its shape to be part of catenary, since the string is finite in length. The wider apart the endings, the smaller part of catenary you see. It is also a common misunderstanding. We assume parabolas as curve of many shapes. In quote, physics law dictates its shape to be part of a whole picture. We get conclusions from extrapolation of transcendental function. The exponent and sine function is the location where random nature or God insert physics constants. The last conclusion is that all transcendental functions are fractals. Fractal means self-similar but different scale. Here are shown five examples of exponential decaying law in different fractal scales. First is the freight train, is big macro world, very heavy mass example. Boltzmann factor is small, used in kinetic gases atoms theory. Radioactive decay goes to the smaller scale, to the nucleus of atom. Fermi Dirac statistical equation describes elementary particles, for example, electrons. And last is light of quanta, photon Planck law of radiation of black body. Sine, cosine, and exponential describe in all physics level that fractal definition in which similar patterns reoccur at progressively smaller scales, and vice versa. We just extrapolate the same exponent-based function over and over again. The fractal pattern in the chaos, we can say that small-scale physics law were probabilistic driving phenomena. A Maxwell-Boltzmann statistic Planck law is also distribution law, and integral of this laws is our big object, macro representation. But we can not ignore that small light particles or atoms are not important to our big object material represented world. Fractals and how dynamics gave this butterfly effect, where a small changes in system can give avalanche effect, exponential progression growing positive feedback loop. The same rule applies to trigonometric function inside brackets. Are the same function variation, but the definition of sine function and shape does not change in process. We investigate mathematics behind linear extrapolation. From here, we transition to how to read physics graph by keeping in mind extrapolation tendency in nature. Let's say we have experimentally gained water density values from temperature. Every 10 degrees Celsius increments. Let's say our goal is to find water density with temperature 153 degrees Celsius. In our dataset, we or computer will extract, or better word, interpolate values between 150 and 160 degrees Celsius with such equation. Polynomial interpolation with n equal 1, solving this equation for y, which is unknown value at x, gives, which is formula for linear interpolation in interval x index 0 and x index 1. Outside this interval, the formula is identical to linear extrapolation. The screenshot from the Wikipedia page shows that the linear formula is identical to linear extrapolation. This moment is important because for transcendental functions, no other method is required, except if you want to reach very accurate precision values. In my video, I'm not trying to prove that my method is better. I try to prove that all transcendental functions are unique functions, one of a kind function that describes our reality. Here is proof of such statement. Here we have water density function graph plot from temperature T value change. As we have seen in our table, delta T equals 10 degrees Celsius, so a small gap between two values. In the graph, we made gap very wide. Wide gap between values, linear extrapolator has inaccuracies. The smooth function of water density from temperature and linear extrapolation line function has a gap that not matches the smooth density function curve. We can say that it's obvious function is nonlinear. So what we expect? But the point is not here. My argument is that catenary exponent-based function, sine, cosine, and Planck law of black body radiation law are unique and always goes same curve path. To prove, we will use linear extrapolation of Planck law between very wide temperature gap by comparing to real formula. These two functions were graphed by using the Planck law equation for two different temperature values T. We graphed two curves by extrapolating mean values of function in between T1 and T2 temperatures, and we get such in between value. And compared to Planck law function equation, and that is very, very close matching curves. Even difference between two temperatures is very wide. We see a linear extrapolation is a powerful tool, even we know that exponent is the most famous nonlinear function. I intentionally show a very big difference in between temperatures. If this gap between T1 and T2 was much smaller, matching of extrapolation be very close to real Planck law equation. My goal is not about the accuracy, but about that trig functions and base e exponent function is unique functions that have fractal self-similar replicating features. When we go to the scalar vector magnitude chapter of this video, such feature will disappear. Important fact, extrapolation can be scalar, proportionality, to have proportionality feature, but scalar vector magnitude cannot be extrapolation. Moody diagram or chart, it can be used to predict pressure drop or flow rate drop in the pipe. It is an experimental based chart. In 1944, Louis Ferry Moody plotted the Darcy-Weisbach friction factor against Reynolds number for various values of relative roughness of pipe epsilon divided by pipe diameter d. I try to explain this Moody chart in a bit different way. to discard Reynolds number and capital letter V, average velocity in a pipe. I wanted by discarding Reynolds number to calculate from initial maximum velocity. Instead, average velocity, initial maximum velocity gives chance to solve the hydrodynamics test before installing the pipeline. But experiment derived Moody chart gives a very good hint that it has a connection with an exponential decaying function. All curves can be extrapolated in between two well-known functions, and their tendency is decaying exponential function. Exponential need put in the air quote because all physics functions have e based, but as in the catenary example, exponential same as trigonometric can be made up from multiple variations. In the Moody chart, we have the x axis Reynolds number is an exponential 10 based increase, which is also very bad and good. Bad that in the age of computer, 10 base systems are not required, but also it is a very distorted chart. It makes chart very out of proportion. I will explain what I mean. Example, very slow velocity laminar flow zone is here. In reality, it's just a very scale-up exponent graph near slow velocity, capital letter V approximately equals zero. When Reynolds number is small and Reynolds number is directly connected to fluid flow in a pipe with diameter D, laminar flow is just very small section of decaying exponential function. Logarithmic scale base 10 stretches exponential function, and in the opposite side of the x-axis we have a flat, near flat line of friction factor. In the case of a very high Reynolds numbers, in logarithmic scale we have exponential function curve asymptotically approaching x-axis value y equals zero. The benefit of a logarithmic base 10 scale is that we have all possible case of flow from low Reynolds number laminar to transitional to fully turbulent flow in one chart. Another very interesting fact is connection with Ohm's law. What happens when resistance R approaching zero and electric current goes to infinity. Yeah, exponent raised by zero equals one solves short circuit and superconductivity phenomena. So exponential is mathematics function requires to solve infinity problem. When wire resistance becomes zero, also, it solves energy conservation law when integration range of exponential function is from zero till infinity. Fluid mechanics and electromechanical friction and resistance are very similar. Wikipedia has a page titled "Electronic Hydraulic Analogy" that raises the question: do in technical science requires memory? For lawyers, memory is everything. In physics, we need to know Newton's law of motion, Bernoulli law of hydrodynamics, Ohm's law of electric current, and that is all. All physics is pattern-driven learning. Memory is not required too much. All fractal patterns and all mathematics science branches is pattern-based learning. I previously showed that exponential functions appear in all scales from trains, atoms, nucleus to light photon. Even formulas are very similar, like Boltzmann factor and Fermi-Dirac statistics are very similar indeed. Of course, that is exaggeration. Memory is required, but it has a seed of truth. But technical science is pattern-driven, not memory-driven science of branch. Are free transcendental fundamental functions. the exponent e based and trigonometric function of sine and cosine. I don't want to discard trigonometric functions. Not forgetting, trigonometric functions are based on our transcendental math constant pi. In picture, we have an example when at moment t equals 0, projectile being projected with initial velocity w bigger than 0, perpendicular to x-axis from height h. In this case, we are interested in how nature deals with an energy conservation law, how nature always maintains energy conservation. Answer is exponential and trigonometric functions. The trajectory of a projectile is this curve. Our task is to calculate the angle of dive into the ground, aka x-axis, this angle. And the trigonometric formula for this angle is equal to. This formula is always true because it sustains energy conservation law potential energy velocity term plus initial velocity w equal to final velocity v index 0. We get the right triangle and Pythagorean theorem rule to sine function with angle theta index 0. Previously, we already established that trajectory is not a straight line. Projectile path trajectory is non-linear curve. How such a thing could happen? When I calculate, I was astonished by such a relation. The answer is also simple. Derivation to solve this problem, we start from a very simple premise. Second Newton law of motion. Later, every step we progress, an equation gets more sophisticated, and in the end, we get this equation of inverse sine equation of angle, and that is suggestion on how to read physics proofs. Starts from the opposite side, from the end to prove to the beginning. The function of the inverse sine equation is where nature maintains energy conservation law. Another example. Let's initial velocity w equals 0. First, it is amazing. It explains gravity potential energy magnitude. This rock on the mountain is stationary, but it contains an absolute energy value equal to unit 1. This fact astonished me, because we easily input numbers into a calculator of sine, cosine, exponent functions. The computer crunches the numbers and spits the result. From a philosophical point of view, it's not much to extract or extrapolate anything. But behind this trigonometric and exponent functions is meaning. The energy of any object, including air that we breathe, is potential energy equal to absolute value unit 1. Human interaction can change this value by projecting projectile perpendicular to the ground with velocity w, or in Planck law of radiation by changing body temperature. God made the integers, all else is a work of man. Mathematician Leopold Kronecker quote. The last chapter is about amplitude in front of sine, cosine, and exponential function, the scalar of a vectorial magnitude value. In this video, I will call a scalar. In my rephrase of mathematician Leonard Kronecker quote is, God made the physics constants in sine transcendental function as x value, amplitude in front of function is the work of man. Are three distinctive physics branches, theoretical physics, experimental physics, and third are applicable physics. We call it engineering. The last chapter is about engineering, human transformation of nature for utilitarian human needs. In Planck law, we can change the temperature T to creating for our needs. In case of sun surface area, we cannot change any values inside exponential. We stuck with fundamental constant as we are including Planck, Boltzmann, and infinite frequency spectrum. Same with G free fall acceleration physics constant. On other planets, it can be different, but law of sine function is still the same on all planets. It is not physics, it is mathematics fundamental laws. For example, potential and kinetic energy. My favorite for obvious reason, it is very slow physics process where you can observe with naked eye, more or less, where electromagnetic photons or gases are atoms is just based on theoretical physics, rigid math proofs. In energy conservation law for kinetic and potential energy, mass has no impact. So yeah, a scalar is not about mass. As we know, mass is just effect of gravity force as is measure of weight. Kinetic velocity is a square root of potential height from the ground. For example, if we have again projectile projected into the air with initial velocity v index 0 and initial angle theta index 0, it will be benchmark trajectory investigation point. We have two extra trajectories with the same initial angle theta index 0, only with two different initial velocities. One is 3 divided by 2 times bigger than the benchmark, and other is 2 times smaller than the benchmark. Velocity is proportional to potential height. Small capital letter S is a scalar factor. In our example, twice smaller maximum flight distance and maximum height will be 4 times smaller compared to the benchmark trajectory. The same scalar increase will be to 3 divided by 2 faster than initial velocity trajectory. One problem with this free trajectory is that they have nothing in common. They obey the same trajectory. I will put in quote parabola. I know that is not parabola in reality, but for sake of proving, we consider. We previously established that parabola is not the same family curve as catenary curve. And we see that in the graph we cannot extrapolate. We can only scale in or scale down the benchmark trajectory. But length is not the same. Every time moment vector's curvature is not the same magnitude and angle. Fractal self-similarity pattern cannot be applied to the trajectory function. Only scale. Trajectories is not fundamental exponential or trigonometric functions. When we're talking about scalar things, mass including and mass flow in hydrodynamics, also we're talking about subjective matters relative to something concrete. The best example is Planck law to some spectrum. What is different between extrapolation fundamental function versus rest of the functions? Exponential functions consist of two fundamental functions, Planck and Boltzmann physics constants. Are these two constants magnitudes high or low? We don't know. We cannot tell. We don't have any point of reference to compare with two values. Other parts of the universe are out of reach where a physics constant can be different in magnitude, and alternative multiverses is out of reach too. Even God cannot tell. One fact is clear, that these constants are necessary to be in such magnitude. For example, electric charge value, if it was 0.6% smaller, carbon never can make organic change of hydrogen, and humanity and all creatures cannot be developed on Earth. same to solar surface temperature and solar spectrum. It is Goldilocks temperature, not too cold, not too hot. We can tell one fact, that these magnitudes of physics constants are precisely engineered to allow appear a conscious beings in the theater of life. For scalar magnitudes, we can tell that the hydrodynamic of such and such is bigger because of hydrostatic height of dam, of our dam of such and such height. Our example, wide body fuselage plane is bigger than ultralight glider based on comparison of masses glider to wide body plane. Scale gives the power to compare one thing to another, and by human's ingenuity and effort, increase in scale or in some instances reduce in scale. For example, in integrated circuit scale down processes. Integrated circuit makes same binary operation but a higher number of circuits in the same surface area. Scale also is very primitive sense of stuff transformation. I started from very primordial and, be honest, very vague concept, and I tried to avoid metaphysical concepts. A different approach compared to my previous video where I argue that our world is holographic based and holographic brains are how mathematical world works. I will put a perfect quote about metaphysics from mathematician Hilary Putnam, and with reference to Nietzsche's most famous aphorism, when you stare into the abyss stares back. Science is wonderful to destroying metaphysical answers, but incapable of providing substitute ones. Science takes away a foundation without providing a replacement. Whether we want to be or not, science has put us in the position of having to live without foundations. It was shocking when Nietzsche said this, but today it is a commonplace. Our historical position and now end to its side it is that of having a philosophize without foundations. I think God is some kind of logician entity, not mathematician or geometrician in some groups show him, who use building blocks as natural numbers including zero and infinity, together with fundamental function and fundamental math constants. Fundamental functions have duality, they based on whole numbers, but the result is irrational functions of sine, cosine and exponent. That is background or science foundation where Nietzsche lacked of it. Today science went into division and destruction of particles in high velocity hadron collider, which leads to nowhere. And Cantor formalism is a very controversial topic in the mathematics community. I think zero and infinity are very controversial topics in at present time too, and the duality of math constant e and pi, which is based on whole numbers but is a continuous, analogous, never repeating, never ending string of irrational numbers. It creates contradiction. Perfect math constant pi describes roundness and is the perfect figure based on perfect whole number sums, which result is an irrational number, cannot be described by ratio of whole numbers. Legend tells that Pythagoreans in ancient Greece were most radical of all Platonist movement, who said that reality is just numbers and nothing else matters. I don't agree with such a radicalization of mathematics. When Pythagorean movement found that square root is irrational number, kept as the biggest secret. In my view, nature of duality it is not just fact, but it requires to exist. As the Quine Putnam Indispensability Argument, also known simply as the Indispensability Argument, is an argument in philosophy of mathematics for the existence of abstract mathematical objects such as numbers and set, a position known as mathematical Platonism, named after the philosopher Willard Quine and Hilary Putnam. The argument is one of the most important arguments in the philosophy of mathematics and is widely considered to be of the best arguments for Platonism. Platonism is the philosophy of mathematics argues that the mathematical sentences seems to imply the existence of mathematical object is supported by appeal to the idea that mathematics should not have its own special semantics. If a sentence Mars is a planet implies the existence of Mars and ascribes it the property of being a planet, then it seems that 2 is a prime number must imply the existence of number 2 as and ascribe to it the property of being prime. Semantics means language in very wide notion. Letters, sentences, symbols, patterns, various shapes, 2D and 3D planes, color palette, and etc. Something that can be interpreted as meaningful, including abstract physics formulas represented as mathematics language notation. Mathematics in special is not casual language as we used to understand. 2 is a prime number must imply the existence of number 2 as ascribed to it the property of being prime. The final step of Quine's argument is to show that regimented scientific theories do in fact make existence claim about mathematical objects. The equation used in science when regimented into first-order logic seems to imply the existence of functions and numbers. For example, Coulomb's law, which describes the force between charged particles, implies the existence of a function which maps the numbers representing the magnitudes of the charges of the particles onto number representing the strength of the forces between them. In the case of pressurization, distance between atoms, a real number line based on the real number system, an atom's charge can be represented by a force field described by math equations. Consider the justification for our belief in the existence of atoms. The atomic theory makes accurate predictions which extend to the observable world. It has led to a deeper understanding of the world as well as further successful research. Despite our lacking direct perception of atoms, we play an indispensable role in atomic theory. According to atomic theory, atoms exist. Thus, according to an intra-theoretic indispensability argument, we should believe that atoms exist. All quotes links are in the description below. That is all, folks. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe.